Welcome to the STEAM channel. In this video, we'll be discussing safety in live steam and large-scale railroading. It's easy to forget large-scale railroad equipment is heavy, and if improperly used can cause serious injuries or even death. Let's start by discussing some best practices for your equipment. We recommend following International Brotherhood Live Steamer standards when constructing your large-scale railroad equipment. This will ensure your coupler heights, wheel profiles, and other specified components are standardized. Maintaining the standard coupler height will decrease the likelihood of cars uncoupling from mismatched couplers. This will also help avoid derailments. You also need to ensure your car frames are built square and level. A twist in a car frame can result in a derailment, which could lead to an injury. Consideration should also be given to a brake system on your equipment to stop your train. Hobbyists only pulling a car or two often rely on their locomotive's brakes to stop. However, you will need to add brakes to your trucks when pulling larger consists. Remember, it's not how many cars you can pull, it's how many cars you can safely stop, especially when hauling people. There are two common types of brake systems used in the live steam and large-scale hobby: straight air brakes and vacuum brakes. You can select the style you're most comfortable with, but these systems are not intercompatible with each other, so you'll have to select one and keep your equipment uniform. Safety chains, while not required everywhere, are a recommended fail-safe to prevent a runaway train. These are particularly important on railroads with steep grades. Runaway cars can severely damage another hobbyist's equipment and can cause grave bodily injury to bystanders. We have seen several instances where cars broke loose from their train and sailed down steep grades. Equipment in this scale is very expensive. Don't be the guy who inadvertently totals out another hobbyist locomotive. It is not appreciated. Traditionally, two hooks were used on either end of a car body and chain was run between the cars. To be more cosmetically tactful, many builders have switched to welding an attachment point directly to the underside of the car frame, and a single chain is then connected with a heavy-duty threaded quick link. Before adding safety chains, it is recommended you look up the local club rules and anywhere else you wish to operate to make sure that your equipment fits their standards. Some may disagree with the use of safety chains and cite that they may pull more cars off the rails in a bad derailment. While this is a possibility, if you are operating at a safe speed, this is a minimum risk compared to the safety benefits gained. Before heading out, you'll also want to thoroughly inspect your equipment to ensure everything is in good mechanical order. Check your brakes and ensure all of your cars are coupled and chained. For steam engineers, ensure your safety valves, water glass valves, cylinder cocks, water pumps, blowdown valves, etc. are in good working order. Keep up on your routine maintenance so safety issues do not arise. Once your equipment is safe to operate, you'll need to keep in mind several operating best practices. Always wear closed-toed shoes, even steel-toed boots if at all possible. Never wear sandals when operating large-scale equipment. Hot ash, burning coal, or steam can cause serious burns if they come into contact with exposed skin. Derailments that cause you to contact the ground can also cause scrapes and other injuries. A foot can also get stuck in a choke point while operating, and a steel-toed boot may prevent a more serious injury. You may also need to stop in an emergency, which may require you to deploy your feet in the balance to slow the train. While not recommended, it is a way to stop a train in an emergency, and we highly recommend you protect your feet and wear proper attire. If you will be running another hobbyist train, ensure familiarity with the brake setup on the equipment so you can safely stop the train. You should also know the capabilities of your equipment, what it can and cannot do. As we mentioned, make sure you can stop the weight of your train before ascending or descending any grades. It is very important to know your stopping distances to avoid accidents. You should also take care to not overload cars with people. Make sure all riders are properly balanced on your cars to avoid derailments. A single rider should be seated in the middle of the car, while two adults should be seated over the trucks on the car when possible. An adult riding with children should be seated in the middle of the car with a child in front of them. Before heading out, understand the signal system of the railroad you're operating on. If you're unsure how it works, ask. Every person at any railroad would be more than happy to help you. It is critically important that you obey the signal system while you're running, as serious head-on collisions can and have occurred when an operator disregards a red signal. Know how to read the signals, where the other trains are, and what direction they are traveling. Situational awareness is required and can often prevent accidents and injuries. This is very important when running steam locomotives, and it is very easy to lose your head in the firebox. Always be aware of the rail traffic and people around you. Parents can be lax watching small children, so be extra careful when you know there are children on the railroad. For example, Chris was operating the 4120 Northern at an event, and a small toddler got away from Mom, ran past the station fence, and onto the main line. Fortunately, Chris was able to slow the train immediately. If his head was down in the firebox, tending to the engine, or just looking around, a serious injury could have occurred. While operating, it is always good practice to maintain at least 100 or more feet between trains on the main line, and to operate them at safe speeds. The need may arise in passing signs as you get closer, but always be sure to keep your distance from other equipment on the main. Also, be sure your equipment is clear of foul points when pulling into sidings, and always throw back the switch to protect your train. You should carry flags to mark the track behind you should a derailment occur, and have someone protect the rear of your train until you are moving again. Some give their conductor a whistle or horn to alert the engineer in case of a derailment. This practice isn't necessary in a small consist, as you, the engineer, will feel the derailment, but on larger trains may be helpful. Some also recommend to carry a flashlight, a cell phone, fire extinguisher, and other spare tools in your train to address any issues that may arise. These may be especially helpful on larger railroads. Ensure you have a functioning headlight and rear marker light at the end of your train for night operations so other operators can see you. It should go without saying, but it is recommended to not operate large-scale railroad equipment under the influence of drugs or alcohol. Always mind Rule G. These are not toys, but heavy equipment. It can do serious damage to other equipment and seriously injure somebody else. It is equally important to park your train and rest should you feel fatigued or tired. Serious collisions have occurred tolling out locomotives because an operator drifted off. Do not remain at throttle when fatigued or impaired. If you are visiting a live steam railroad, it is important to respect the property of others and be aware of where you are. Always stay off the tracks. Aside from the inherent safety risk of falling, standing on the rails can cause damage to the railroad itself and the right-of-way. Make sure all small children or animals are well supervised, looked after, and under control. Do not let them touch your equipment, and please do not take small children into the steaming bay areas while hobbyists are firing up locomotives unless you are invited in. There is a lot going on in these areas, especially during larger meets, and a small child could be burned by steam, falling cinders, or by coming into contact with a hot locomotive. Each hobbyist is busy servicing his or her locomotive and may not notice a small child around before rolling a locomotive to grease the running gear. A little one can easily be burned by steam coming on the cylinder cocks, or they are standing in the blind spot on the other side of the engine during this process. While riding trains, children must be seated on the train car and cannot ride on a parent's lap. All children must ride with an adult. All passengers must also ride trains face forward and are asked not to lean, reach out for objects, drag feet, or take any photography while the train is in motion, as trains are derailed by people leaning over with a camera. If you drop something, alert the engineer and they will stop the train so you can collect it. Do not jump off a moving train. For the older kids, please place all walking sticks, canes, or crutches level on the car floor. Do not hold these items vertically. Many groups would not allow an infant on their public hauling trains, but if you're going to put a car seat on a car, use one with a very low center of gravity. We recommend this not be done at all unless the infant is yours and you are a seasoned hobbyist on your own equipment. When storing equipment, never keep gasoline or other flammable materials in your train storage area, and be sure to keep gas cans and other flammable substances out of the steaming bay area when possible. Propane tanks should be stored in designated outdoor storage spots away from other flammable materials. The safety measures we've touched on will help eliminate accidents and injuries during your enjoyment of the large-scale railroad hobby. Ultimately, if something seems unsafe, it probably is. Ultimately, it comes down to common sense and don't be stupid, stupid. My name is Blake Michoud. You're watching the Steam Channel. We'll see you next time.
Thank you for watching this video here on the Steam Channel. We hope you enjoyed it. Shovel on more coal to the fire and enjoy another high-quality Steam video by clicking on one of the video previews to your right. Consider subscribing to the channel so you won't miss our future content.